Hello everyone, today we are going to be learning how to use the command through curves mesh in NX, which is essentially an advanced loft if you're used to SOLIDWORKS terminology. First thing we're going to do is we're going to just have an arbitrary shape. We're going to do a solid rectangle in one area. And then we're going to do an arbitrary rectangle in another area. I'm actually going to use datum cesis for the flexibility and also to highlight just how powerful through curves mesh can be, because I'm going to put it at a strange angle that we don't even know what it is, but we'll show how it still works regardless. So again, just make another arbitrary rectangle. I'll extrude it in the other direction. So what I want to do here is I want to join these two faces. In order to do that, what I'm going to do is use four splines to create smooth lines to join these two. I'm going to click on this corner and click on another corner. It's going to put a line down. Then I'm going to select the first point, and I will change continuity type to tangent and specify the tangent, and I'm going to specify this edge as the tangent so that this line is tangential to that edge there. I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing for the second point, the end point here. Again, continuity type tangent, specify tangent, and I'm going to select that line right over there, that edge right over there. If you'll notice, it decided to put the vector going in the opposite direction of what we want, so I will reverse using this button here. And now it's nice and smooth. I'm going to now hit apply and do the same thing for our next corners. Again, click the first point here in the menu, continuity type tangent, specify tangent, this edge. For the next one, continuity type tangent, specify tangent, this edge. Again, it flipped. We'll flip it back, no problem. Okay, now that we have all four lines specified, we are going to go ahead and use the through curves mesh command. You can find it under surface. It's right over here, through curves mesh. What you're going to do is you're going to create four sheets to define the four faces that we have here. Primary curves and cross curves, these are interchangeable for our purposes. I'll show you how they work. It'll be clear what you do. You click on one edge, and then you click on the matching edge, but you're going to list it as a new primary curve. So you hit this plus button, and then it becomes a matching edge. Now you select cross curves, and you select one edge, and a new cross curve, matching edge. And as you can see, NX is creating a sheet for that region. Now, which one the primary curve is and which one the cross curve is, it doesn't really matter. So we are going to do it this way, but if I selected the other curves, the other edges, it really wouldn't matter. It would still work just as fine. We'll do it again. A shortcut would be to use the middle mouse button, so I click. And then as you can see, this blue plus sign is highlighted blue. That means if I use my middle mouse button, click, it's ready for me to select a new one. I select this one here. Good. Now I go to cross curves, click this one, middle mouse button, it's ready to select the next one. Click it over here. There we go, another sheet. Hit apply. We have one more left. This one. And this one. Cross curves, this one, middle mouse button, this one. Okay, now if you were creating a sheet body, where these were actually not solids but sheets. You would essentially be ready to sew this all together, and you would have a tube, a hollow tube that would be constant throughout. But if you actually want to make this a solid, what you would need to do now is hide those solid bodies that we started with, so that we only have the sheet body. And we're going to put down two more through curves meshes. So again, select one, middle click, the other, cross curves, one, middle click, the other, hit apply. I think you see what we're doing here. We're creating a solid, airtight shape that will allow us to now make it into a solid. So right now we have a closed sheet body. If I show you a section view, you can see that it's hollow inside. Okay. So to make it a solid piece, what we're going to do is we're going to sew it. So under the surface ribbon, there is the sew command right over here. And what you're going to do is you're going to select one face and then select all the other faces nearby as long as they are touching, which of course they are since that is the shape that we're creating here. Now, when you hit OK, it's going to turn it into a solid. And the reason that it will do that is I have body type set to solid. If I wanted it to still be a sheet, but I just wanted these to be one sheet body, I'd select sheet here, but in our cases we do want it to be a solid. So I have solid selected, hit OK. Now if I show you my section plane, there it is. You can see it's a solid. It is not hollow. So now if we go ahead and unhide those previously hidden bodies that we started with, we can see we have one consistent shape. And if we want to make it one piece now, we can use the unite command. And again, select one item, and then we select the following two, hit OK, and now it is all one big chunk. Again, I can show you section. There it is. It's all one big piece. And now, since we have it that way, you can actually go ahead and you can even say put a radius on the edge, and since it's all one piece, it will allow us to do it all together. There it is. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe button. And if you have any recommendations or questions, please put that in the comments section as well. Thank you very much. Bye.